Hey everybody, how's it going? I really hope you had a wonderful holiday season. Welcome back to Dunswell in the year 2022. In this episode, I'll be focusing my attention mostly to the city of Brightwood today, because there's a few things I would like to get done. First thing is, I would like to reach 75,000 people. It's been a goal of mine for the last 10 episodes, and I'd like to finally achieve it in this episode. I think we can do it because we have a relatively high residential demand right here and a ton of room to expand over here in Brightwood. You know, we don't have any room at all left in Dunswell, but we have plenty of room in Brightwood. So I think it's the perfect episode to just hammer down some residential and get to 75,000 people. I'll just briefly run down why I would like to do that. That is simply because it's the last milestone available in the game. So after that, there is no more milestones. In this Megalopolis milestone, we finally unlock one more square. The final square that is unlockable by default, you know, using the 9 tiles that are available. We unlock some monuments, which I don't really care about. And interestingly enough, we unlock the International Airport, the Cargo Airport Hub, and the Metropolitan Airport, which I most likely will not be placing down any of these buildings because in the next few days is the release of the new airport DLC. So this is going to be super exciting. I'm thinking of building a custom airport over here maybe. There's just a ton of land and it's very flat. I think this would be an optimal area to build an airport. But that is to come in the following weeks. On January 25th is when the airport's DLC is released. So shortly after that, I will be building an airport. All right, so without further ado, guys, let's jump right into this episode and start laying down some residential zonage. And then I would like to get into some other things while we wait for the city to expand. So the first thing I want to do is make sure we have all of our services placed down, starting with healthcare. I think we're okay. You know, we have a large capacity central hospital over here, which is far from being overrun. So I think we're okay for healthcare. Death care, I think it's the same story. We have a cemetery over here, which is set to empty. We have a crematorium right here by the cemetery. We have another one over here, and then another one right over here on the other side of town. So I think we're okay. As far as child care, there's gonna be a ton of new people over here. So let's, I'm gonna place the child care building out here in the burbs, right over here. Oh, maybe that's not the best place just because of the terrain. That's probably not the best place either. Yeah, whatever, it's fine. I'll keep one of them. And then elder care, this is not gonna be an issue right now, but I'm gonna go ahead and place an elder care building right here because it will be a problem in the future. I mean, these buildings don't really, they're not essential, but they just kind of help out the neighboring region. So I'll go ahead and place those. Maybe a sauna as well to promote health. What does this do anyways? It's a health bonus to the neighborhood around them and increases happiness. Okay. This is a pretty good thing to have. So let's place that down. Maybe a sports gymnasium as well. And I think that's, I'm all right with that for now. Then super important is fire protection. So let's go and place down a fire hall because we could use another one over here in this part of town. I'm gonna go ahead and place this right by the crematorium. Very convenient. If ever a fire breaks out at the crematorium, you know, the firemen just have to literally walk over to the next property. And then a police station. Our zone is kind of fading away over here, so I'm going to place a police station right here. And then last but not least, let's place down some educational buildings. Because right now, as far as elementary schools goes, we could use another one. I'll place it right over here, and then it's kind of the same story with our high schools. Let's place another one right about here. All right, so as far as services, I think we're in the clear. I'll just have to provide some water to some of these areas. right, I think that's good for now. And let's start to go wild with some residential zoning. Just basically lays the residential zone down wherever it can fit, with the exception of a few little spots. I like to, you know, as I said in a previous episode, I like to dot around some little convenience stores and things like that. You know, every neighborhood has its little convenience store where you can go and buy milk and all the basic necessities. So Dunswell, or Brightwood, I should say, is kind of going to be that the same thing. Oh, you know what? Before I get too carried away here, I should check the zonage. Yeah, I'm gonna encompass this entire thing in the actual Brightwood zone. And that's just to make sure that there's no European buildings that are gonna start spriting up. And then let's maybe mix a little bit of high density in here. So, you know, we always have to have some luxury condos right by the water. Some apartment buildings here and there. And the rest will be low density residential. Why not some cliffside houses too? We'll have this be like one of the more luxurious parts of town. Little something like that. There. So I guess that'll keep the town busy for a little while. At this point, we just have to wait it out, wait until the city expands. Actually, maybe I'll just add another little neighborhood over here. God, look at this hilly terrain. I gotta adjust this. Actually, let's do this. I'm going to take this node along with a bunch of other nodes, and I am going to slope everything. Oh yeah, that's way better. I mean, it's kind of better. It's not perfect, but it's okay. Oops. All right, I think we're okay with that for now. Okay, so now as we wait for this neighborhood to develop, which I'm really hoping this is going to be enough for 75,000 people. But look at that. Just with the small amount of residential buildings that have sprawled up, it's basically just already killed my residential demand. That's just how the game works. But the good thing is there's so much surplus zonage that any residential demand that does come up will immediately be eaten up and then just build somewhere over here. And I actually think it might be already built up here as far as it could go. But anyways, we have all of this zone that needs to be developed. So I think it's going to keep the town busy for the next little while. Now, there is one thing that I would like to get done in this episode, and it has been bugging me for the last little while, and I'm sure it's been bugging you guys, is the traffic. Traffic is a nightmare, not only in Brightwood, but in Dunswell as well. So along this main highway here, traffic is always pretty terrible. I know some of you guys have pointed that out to me a bunch of times, and I've kind of been ignoring it for the last few episodes because there's just so much more other things that need to get done. But Anyway, we'll have to address the traffic issue in Dunswell at some point. But for now, just with this episode being focused on Brightwood, I think we should start over here. Now, there's a bunch of things that can be done to improve this interchange. First of all, the design of it is not really that great. There's too many intersections really close to each other. So this is probably the main thing that's causing all of this traffic. Public transportation as well is not very ideal over here. So this is, again, a major thing that you guys have pointed out to me multiple times, but I just kind of ignored it. I'm sorry about that, guys. But I will address this, and I know how to fix this now because I have watched a few tutorials on how to fix bus networks. All right, so after you guys pointed out a bunch of times to me that these loop configurations aren't really ideal, I went to check out why that was. I watched a few YouTube tutorials, and I learned why these loops aren't really the best option. The best alternative to this is creating these sort of grid patterns that collapse back on each other. So really there should be like another line going parallel to this one going in the opposite direction. So that would be a very ideal thing to do eventually. I'm not going to get there this episode. You know, we can only do so much in a short amount of time, but I just want to make you guys aware that I am aware. But yes, this is one thing that could be done to fix this interchange to a certain extent, is just to improve the public transportation. So in Brightwood, we have buses and the metro, which is being used a fair bit. But the main thing is we have to redesign this interchange, or at least improve it. So I'm kind of surprised right now because this used to be just filled with cars. So it's not doing too bad at the very moment. But anyways, I'm going to take the time to fix this. And the first thing I want to do is to prevent vehicles from doing this. You know, merging all the way from the left lane. This is just a terrible thing to do. You know, I guess City Skylines does have quite a bit of realism because, I mean, that's, people do that. But we're going to stop that today. People will no longer be able to do that. And instead, you'll have to be on the farthest right lane in order to exit the highway. So these people will only be able to go right, and then these people only be able to go left. And the rest can do whatever they want, but actually, you know what? Before I go any further, I'm gonna reconfigure this interchange. Not by a lot, but I'm going to convert this into, oh crap, that's not good. There. I have to go into bridge mode. I'm going to convert this into a 6-lane road because I now have dedicated turning lanes. So I can do this now. So I can force the left lane to turn left, which it probably already was. Or maybe not, actually. And then I'll go ahead and do the same thing over on this side. This lane will go straight. This lane will go straight. And then this lane will either turn right or go straight. And then this intersection will look a little bit like this. There, and let's go fix the other side. So this lane will turn right. Oh, you know what? You know what I should do? Because this is a big problem. Let me explain here. So look at this traffic. This traffic is being backed up all the way almost to this bridge over here. And most of the traffic, from what I've noticed, is trying to turn right. So what I'll do is convert this section of road to a 6-lane as well. And then let's go back into the lane controller. This will be a dedicated right turn. And then this lane will have these two lanes as an option. And then these two lanes as an option. This is probably not a very safe thing, but anyways. And then basically the only option from here will either be to go left. The center lane will be able to go left. Any other lane, the only option will be to go straight out. Okay. So this is a good start. Maybe let's fix this interchange here. There's probably not a whole lot to be done, honestly. I think this lane turns right. Honestly, this is probably okay. I'm gonna leave this like it is. And really, this whole like part of town should be demolished. Like, there shouldn't even be an interchange here. An intersection. I could place the hospital like along this road and like just have this running all the way down. It would probably help out a lot. Anyways, not a big deal. Okay, so this is the first thing that we can do. The second thing that I will toy around with is the timed traffic lights. So I'll give you guys a little disclaimer. I'm by no means an expert when it comes to timed traffic lights. The lane connector. I can get around, like, it's super simple to use, it's pretty self-explanatory, but timed traffic lights, oh, that's another monster. But anyways, today's the day that I'm going to dabble with it and try to create something that works. I have watched a couple of tutorials on how to use this, and I think I have it down pat, but anyways, let's just see what we can do here. So I'm going to select these two nodes at each end of our diamond interchange. And what I'm going to do is create a step. But actually, before doing that, I'm going to... How do I add a junction to this traffic light? Nope. Hold on. I want to add another light. But actually, I think I can do this, actually. Here, I'm just going to deselect everything. Remove light, and then I can do control click, and then I can manually customize these steps. Okay, so this light here, I want to customize this light. How do I do that? I'm gonna go stop. Okay, yeah, and then I can go edit. All right. But this is weird. There should be like two lanes, but anyways. So when this light's green, you can either turn left or go straight. So this is step one. And I want this to be minimum 3 seconds. Let's go like minimum 5 seconds, and then maximum, let's do 15 seconds is what was happening in the tutorial that I was watching. So let's start with that. Let's go down to the second light, which gives the ability of these people to go straight or turn right, and these people to turn right, which makes sense. And then I'm just gonna change the time to 15 seconds max. 5 seconds minimum. And let's go to the third step, which gives these people the ability to go whichever direction they want, which is pretty much what I want. So this was actually a little bit easier than I thought, because in the tutorial that I was watching, I can post a link down in the description, this quick setup was not an option. You had to do everything manually. It was kind of a pain. And then our pedestrian lights are automatic, of course, so that's really convenient. And then I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing over on this intersection. Oh crap, this is paused. I got to go start. There. Let's go over here. Let's stop it. Go edit. 15 seconds, 5 seconds. And let's change this up. There we are. So yeah, this is probably the best way to do it, honestly. Let's see if there's any improvement with this configuration. So let's just run the simulation. Look at that, we're at 70, just above 70,000 people, almost to 71. Great news. All right, so we have... Oh yeah, look at that. Seems to be working. Maybe I should add some more time to each light. Maybe 20 seconds isn't enough. Or 15 seconds. Maybe I should put it to 20. Oh crap. Okay, hold on. I know what's going on here. So this lane, I'm going to remove. I will remove the ability to go into the center lane, and I'll do these two lanes here. There, because that was just causing a mess. And then I'll do the same thing over here. These people will only be able to go into these two lanes, and then I'll remove this lane. There. That should help out. Is this helping at all? Or is it making it worse? Might be making it worse, guys. I don't know. I may need some of your guidance, guys. I know a lot of you are traffic experts. I'll have to get Biffa to review my city. Once, like, the city's complete, I'll have to get him to get my traffic up. Because right now I'm sitting at, what, 66%? 67. Oh my god, look at that. We gained a percent. Which is pretty terrible, but not as bad as I thought, honestly. Because, like, most of the city's like a greenish-brown color, which isn't terrible. It's just downtown a little bit, maybe in the industrial sector. The worst of it's right here. Like, look at that. Yeah, this is like the worst area here. All right, well, I guess it's as good as it's gonna get for here. I don't know what else I can do. Oh, crap, this isn't even working. Forgot to hit start. That might have been it, guys. I forgot to hit start. All right, well, now we can really test it out. Oh yeah, look at that. I'm gonna modify the time here. Hold on. Time traffic lights. Go here. Go stop, and then view. I'm going to increase the time for this interchange to 25 seconds, so it's going to be a lot longer, just because the traffic is all coming from there. And let's start it again. And then from this intersection, it's going to be the opposite. Let's go stop, view. Okay. Why is there a left turn lane? Shouldn't be a left turn lane. How do I... Oh, crap. Okay, sorry. That's from there. Man, this mod's confusing. Okay, so I want to go here and then 20 seconds. There. So it'll give ample time for everybody to turn right. Honestly, they should be able to turn right on a red light anyways. There should be like an actual like merge lane that just allows them to turn right. I wonder if there's a way to do that. Is there a way to do that? Oh crap, I keep forgetting to press start. Oh, I know. Hold on. I know. Okay, I'm gonna go stop. I'm gonna go view. I think it was the second one. Yes. So. What? Oh, I can't change this? Oh, I have to go edit. There. Then we'll do save. And then I'll go to the first one here. Turn right, save, edit, turn right, save. Okay. So basically, anybody is able to turn right at any time. Look at this. Watch this, guys. This is amazing. Look at that. Everybody's just turning right. All the time. Non-stop right turns. Oh man, look at that. This was like the smartest move of the day. Look at that. Boom. Instantly just clears up this entire road. Holy crap, guys. Sometimes I'm a genius. Incredible. Look at that. Just boom. Constant right turns. And then even when there's left turns, there's right turns. Which is okay, I guess. I mean, this is how real life works, right? Like, if somebody's making a left turn and they have the left arrow, I mean, you can technically just turn right whenever you want, like, as long as there's a clearing. Anyways, okay, well, I think I'm just about done with this interchange, guys. Let me know if there's anything I can do differently here. If there's anything I can improve on, just drop a comment down below. I'm sure that you guys can just figure something out that I would never have thought of. But yeah. Okay, so for the next little bit, guys, what I think I'm going to do... we're only at 71,500 people. Okay, so I'm going to skip ahead until we reach 75,000 people. And that's basically just because at this point, I think this is a waiting game. It's basically just waiting until we get to 75,000 people, because there looks to me like there should be enough zonage to reach that milestone. I think I may just add a couple streets here. Hey guys, check this out. We made it. 75,000 people. All right. Well, that's it. We finished the game. See you guys. No, I'm just kidding. Still plenty of stuff left to do. Now, here's the situation. I don't think there's a whole lot that can be done for this interchange per se. It's just too compact. There's too many interchanges in very close proximity. Until we can build another entrance into Brightwood, this is going to continue to be a traffic nightmare. So, with us reaching 75,000 people, this fortunately gives me access to another square. So, for the rest of this episode, I'm going to purchase this square up here, which now gives me access to all of this land. I will be constructing an additional interchange over in this part of town. So, I'm sure this is going to help somewhat. Oh my god, look at this garbage problem. This is not good. So I'm going to pause the game right away before it gets any worse, and I'm going to take another couple of minutes to work on an interchange over here that will hopefully alleviate all of the traffic coming through this interchange. So here we go. Alright guys, here you have it. The beautiful interchange. I'm actually quite proud of this one. It was quite a challenge, honestly, just with the terrain, with this being such a steep hill. I kind of had to move away from my original plan of having this main road coming off of this one here. So I just kind of zigzagged its way over here. So not a big change, but it does look really, really cool. So anyways, that's going to be it for this interchange, but also this episode. So guys, thanks so much for watching. Unfortunately, it's not really resulting in, you know, the traffic reduction along this road, but, you know, there may be some other things we can do in the future. I'll leave that up to you guys. Let me know what the best course of action is for this situation. So guys, thanks again for watching. Leave a like, leave a comment, be sure to subscribe to the channel, and until the next episode, take care.